you've been a fan of Anathema before you joined the band, and you've been a metalhead as well, you must be aware of most metalhead think that, well, Anathema was better when they were more doom, blah blah blah. Do you think at this point in the band it will be just a waste of time for them to go back to that sound?
Nah, no. The band will never go back to play metal.
Yeah.
Never. That's not gonna happen. We did do the shows, the Resonance shows.
Yeah.
With Darren White and Duncan Patterson. Recently we toured South America, and Duncan is living in Mexico,
uh-huh.
So we also played the show with us, which
yeah.
was really nice.
Right.
He's a lovely guy. Both Darren and Duncan are great guys. But I you know, in like writing a metal album again, that's not gonna happen.
That's not gonna happen.
No, it's not gonna happen. It's like no one in the band has it anymore. I mean, no one feels, you know, as a metal musician in a way. Everyone is more about rock, like heavy rock. It's like if you think about metal, you think about distortion, like,
mm-hmm.
And in the band everyone likes the type of distortion, like rock distortion, like AC/DC, rather than you know, heavier stuff, you know, like doom stuff or anything. So everyone is much more to the rock side than to the metal side.
Right.
So that's...
Well, let's talk a bit about you. You know, when people mention you, I always remember special album you did with Christopher from Older, 2006, right? Do you think that was just that time in your life and one time thing, or do you thought
in a way,
any time
that
going
was,
back?
In a way, that was actually an album that's more proggy than another. In a way, yeah. I mean, it was very special back then. Me and Chris talked briefly about doing it again, but at the same time he's so busy with Over, I'm really busy with Anathema as well.
Mm-hmm.
You never know if the stars will align one day and we'll do another album, but for now it should be considered that something that was done, you know, at that time, and it's closed. But you never know. I can't really say never.
Right.
In this subject. I really like Chris, he's a great guy as well. We haven't been in touch as much as we used to be now, and I think it's also my fault because I'm always away. But if somehow we find a way to work together again, I would love to.
Right. Well, you think you play guitars, you play bass, but is drums your drug of choice?
Yeah, totally.
Yeah.
Yeah, totally. Especially on stage.
Yeah.
When this thing with, you know, the two drummers thing started, before that I was playing keyboards.
Yeah, yeah.
And sometimes, I mean, this creates kind of a weird vibe sometimes, because it's like sometimes they want me to play drums, but I know John wants to play drums and I feel bad. And at the same time, sometimes John is playing drums on songs and I would like to play drums. So I don't think this is not very, you know, well managed yet. I think we're probably still working on it. But I told him more than once that I don't mind going back to keyboards. But to be honest, I fucking hate to play keyboards. I like to play, you know, at home, you know, work, you know, as a producer, as
yeah.
a songwriter, you know, being at home with a glass of wine, playing some piano, writing some music. I love that. But when I'm on a stage, I really need to be playing drums. But I see that this, you know, I think this band needs more of a keyboard player, needs more a keyboard player than two drummers.
Yeah.
I mean, two drummers is a bit overkill, to be honest, for the type of music that we do. And I think we actually need a keyboard player. So I'm always trying to tell them, are you sure you want to keep doing this? I don't mind going back to keyboards because I think the music needs that.
Yeah.
You know, but it's, they're the bosses. So.
Right. So in these 6 years of Anathema, did you receive any offer that you say, oh, fuck, I would love to take that job, but you were doing the Anathema thing?
Nothing too big. Well, some studio related stuff.
Yeah.
I know I did lose some jobs just for the fact that I was on tour.
Yeah.
But nothing that important. Because people that really want to work with me, they will wait. If you know, if I'm not available, they'll wait a couple of months and then I'll be available and then we'll do it. But no, nothing major. I don't think I ever lost like a big opportunity, you know, as a producer or as a musician, for the fact that I was away on tour.
Awesome. So, in your words, do you still consider Anathema a prog band, actually?
I'm not sure if anyone in the band actually agrees with,
yeah,
with the fact that, you know, most people call Anathema or label Anathema as a prog band. I think all of us just think as it as a rock band, like a heavy rock band or something like that, with a lot of, you know, more kind of alternative stuff, electronic stuff,
yeah,
and ambiental stuff. So it's, but I mean, people can call us whatever they want, but we don't really see ourselves as a prog band, I think.
Right. So talking about electronics, well, the album is awesome. People really enjoy it, but there were some mixed reviews from people say that it has too much electronic. You playing synth and keyboards for and band and everything. After you read or heard these talks about people, did you consider also that maybe this album has too much of it, or?
I don't think so. I mean, it's, I didn't see the reviews.
Yeah.
And to be honest, it's like I'm not a big opinionate. I don't know how to say this, but you know, I don't really, you know, I don't really put a lot of work into that department in the band. So that's mostly, that comes mostly from Vinny, John, and Danny. But, you know, as a listener myself, I really don't think there's too much electronic. I mean, it's exactly as much electronics as we wanted. So
right.
I think it works well with the music. I would say so. You know.
So, are you 100% happy with your input on this album, especially, you know, you entered the band in 2011, I think?
Yeah.
Now, on the Optimist?
Well, I do what I can. I mean, it's like, there's really not a lot of space for me to be creative in the band, because there's a lot of, there's already so much creativity going on in the band, so it's... There's really not a lot of space for me. I just, you know, do pretty much whatever they want me to do. I give my opinion every once in a while, but I just leave it to them.
Yeah.
I'm more about, you know, playing it live.
Right.
And as far as the creative side goes, it's totally up to them.
Right. Yesterday I saw your video, your drum cam video on Sony Sphere here in the UK, and John went next to you. Playing also with the
bass,
yeah, exactly. Do you still feel weird seeing him playing next to you?
Yeah, I still feel weird about the situation, to be honest.
Yeah.
And you know, sometimes I just feel like I should go back on keyboards and John should play drums. But you know, it's their decision. As I said, it's like I just do whatever they want me to do. So I just want to play, so I don't really care what I'm playing.
Right.
I can play drums and I can play keyboards, so it's whatever. You know, it's like they say, it's like we need to serve the music, so it's like whatever is necessary for the music, so it's pretty much
Not talking about money, but do you feel like Anathema has gained all that it deserves as a band? Like too many years touring, playing, recording?
I don't want to sound greedy, because if I say it doesn't, sounds like we are all a bit too greedy. I mean, it's true that the band's been you know, around for a long time, and sometimes it's tough, because, you know, touring, it takes a big, you know, I mean, it's financially, it's very heavy to tour.
It's
a lot of expenses, and sometimes you have to keep the costs down, and sometimes I feel like the band should be at a level that would allow us to, like, for instance, we would love to tour with an LED wall instead of a projector, but we couldn't afford it.
Right.
Because touring with an LED wall is fucking expensive. So we're touring with a projector instead, which brings a lot of problems. It takes a lot of time to set up.
Yeah.
And if the band was bigger, I mean financially bigger, we could definitely
afford that. Yeah.
Instead of the projector. So maybe, yeah, I wish the band was, you know, at a bigger stage right now.
Right.
But I can't really complain, because a lot of bands from the same kind of segment, bands that I grew up listening to as well, like My Dying Bride, or, you know, even Paradise Lost, I don't think they are not doing, you know,
they're playing, not bigger,
they're not
in
bigger than Anathema right now. They're not playing bigger crowds than we are. And I think sometimes we have bigger crowds and, you know, better conditions on shows, like better venues as well. So I think, yeah, I think I definitely think it's growing. It's not at the point that I would like to, but at the same time I'm happy
yeah
because because it's not that bad.
Great. It's,